I was born and raised in a Christian home. I was baptized as a baby, went to church every Sunday and Sunday school as a child. My mother would pray with me every day and sometimes sing songs about Jesus to me, which I loved. My father would read the Bible after supper every night, which I also loved. For a time, my mother was not able to pray with me at bedtime, probably when my sister or brother was born. I was 4 or 5 years old. She would remind me, say your prayers, but I would forget. Every night, the same routine. By the end of the week, I realized that I had forgotten to pray all that week, and I had better make up for it. So for Monday, now I lay me down to sleep. And then for Tuesday, now I lay me down to sleep. But then I stopped. Repeating the same prayer over and over didn't make any sense. And I began to think about what prayer and the Bible and Jesus was all about. I was thinking all of a sudden. As I was thinking, all of a sudden, the Lord became very real to me. He showed himself so clearly, it was easy for me to believe that he was real and that he loved me. As a little child, all I could see was Jesus. I had no fear because I knew that God was so close to me. I sang for joy during the early years of my life. As I grew up, the Bible fascinated me. I couldn't get enough. As a child, I tried to understand as much as I could. Even though I didn't have my own Bible, the Lord would teach me things during the week, and so often what he taught me was preached about on the following Sunday. Then in my early teens, I got my own Bible. I ate it. I read, wrote, memorized as much as I could, and when I could. But as I learned more, I realized how unworthy I was of God's grace. He forgave all my sins and continues to forgive me. It amazed me and continues to amaze me that he saved even me. At the age of 19, I did my professional faith at the church we attended. 10 years later, we left that church and joined a church that practiced believer's baptism. I didn't feel the need to be baptized at that time since I was already baptized, but more so because I had done my profession of faith. As time went on, the Lord worked a desire in my heart to be baptized, but I didn't. I made excuses. For 23 years, I made excuses. But now it's time. I need to take the step of obedience and be baptized.
For myself. I'm eternally grateful for the cross and this opportunity to bring repentance. I'm regularly brought back to the cross and to my knees as I attempt to live Christ, live my life as an example to my children and others without hypocrisy.
Amen. Amen. And Tammy, why do you want to be baptized today?
Because I want to be obedient, finally.